Hi students, I am Shrimati Anupama Rao from Mangala Vidya Mandira. Students, let us learn a new unit called Hobbies. In this unit, we are going to learn a new poem and a lesson. Poem name is My Hobby. Students, you have to tell the meaning of hobbies. Yes, ಹವ್ಯಾಸಗಳು. ಮೈ ಹಾಬಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ನನ್ನ ಹವ್ಯಾಸ. ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ರಿಪೀಟ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಮೀ. ಮೈ ಹಾಬಿ ಅನಾನಿಮಸ್. ದ ಸ್ಕೈ ಈಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಬ್ಲೂ ಆಸ್ ದ ಹೆವನ್ಸ್. ದ ಕ್ರೌಡ್ ನೋ ವೇರ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಫೌಂಡ್. ದ ಬರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ ಸಿಂಗಿಂಗ್. ಓ ವಾಟ್ ಅನ್ ಎಂಚಾಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಸೌಂಡ್. No one knows why I do this, why I sit hours carelessly away. This sketching is my hobby. This world of beauty is where I play. So now I lie here drawing. Oh, what a beautiful scene. This world is my cherished love, so peaceful, so serene. Children, here the poet is appreciating the beauty of nature. He is speaking about his hobby of sketching the beautiful nature. The sky is as blue as the heavens. He is comparing the sky to the heaven. Swargakke ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಯಾವುದನ್ನು? ಆಕಾಶವನ್ನು. ದ ಕ್ರೌಡ್ ನೋ ವೇರ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಫೌಂಡ್. ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಕ್ರೌಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಸೋ ಕಾಮ್. ದ ಬರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ ಸಿಂಗಿಂಗ್. ದ ಬರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಸಿಂಗಿಂಗ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಎಂಚಾಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಸೌಂಡ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್? Oh, what an enchanting sound. The birds singing is the enchanting sound. No one knows why I do this, why I sit hours carelessly away. This sketching is my hobby. What is the hobby of the speaker? Sketching. The hobby of the speaker is sketching. This world of beauty is where I play. So now I lie here drawing. Oh, what a beautiful scene. This world is my cherished love. Cherished means desired. Bayasidantaha. So peaceful, so serene. The word meaning of serene is calm, prashantavada. How is the nature? It is so calm. It is so beautiful. Let us look at the new words. Sketch, draw, enchanting, very pleasant, attractive, cherished, desired, serene, calm. Children, what is the enchanting sound? Can you tell the answer? Yes, the birds' happy singing is the enchanting sound. What is the hobby of the speaker? The hobby of the speaker is sketching. The speaker says he sits carelessly away because he loves nature. The speaker says the world is so peaceful, so serene. Children, for each word, four more words are given. Circle the word which means the same as the given word. One has been done for you. Sketch. And they have circled the word draw. The meaning of sketch is draw. Enchanting. There are four options. Children, can you choose the correct answer? Yes, it's attractive. So you have to circle the word attractive. Cherished, desired. What is the meaning of cherished? Desired. Serene, calm. So you have to circle the word calm. Complete each of the following sentences with the right word. These words are given in brackets, but their spellings are jumbled. First one. The ink is as red as dash. Children, can you guess the word? Yes, it is blood. Second one. The birds are happy dash. Children, now can you guess the word? Yes, it's singing. Third one. Sketching is my dash. Sketching is my hobby. So now I like your dash. So now I like your drawing. This world is my cherished dash. This world is my cherished love. Next one. Identify the pairs of rhyming words from the poem. Make a list of the words in your notebook. One is given. Sound, found. Children, you have to search for the rhyming words from the poem. Work with the partner. Think of more words that rhyme with the words. One has been done for you. Sound, found, round, bound. These all are rhyming words. Second one. Park, shark, mark, dark. Third one. Nest, fest, rest, best. Then some pictures are given below. Color them as you like. Students, let us learn a new lesson now. Good hobbies. Olle havyasagalu. Should we have good hobbies or bad hobbies? Good hobbies. There lived a cute boy at Tiruchirappalli in Tamil Nadu. He was born on November 7th, 1888. There was a boy at Tiruchirappalli in Tamil Nadu. He was very clever and smart. He was very intelligent. He was good in his studies and had good hobbies too. ಕಲಿಕೆಯಲ್ಲೂ ತುಂಬ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿದ್ದ, ಹಾಗೆ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಹವ್ಯಾಸಗಳನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಹೊಂದಿದ್ದ. ಹಿ ಲವ್ ಟು ಸ್ವಿಮ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವಿಲೇಜ್ ಪಾಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅವರ್ಸ್. ಹಿ ಲವ್ ಟು ಸ್ವಿಮ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವಿಲೇಜ್ ಪಾಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅವರ್ಸ್. ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಹಾಬಿ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ವಿಮ್ಮಿಂಗ್. ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಸ್ವಿಮ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅವರ್ಸ್. He had so many friends to play with. He had so many friends to play with, just like you children. They loved flying kites. So here you can see one more hobby, that is flying kites. Making friends, flying kites, swimming. They used to make colorful kites. His friends were making colorful kites. What do you mean by kites, children? You all know very much, right? You all like very much. Kite means gaalipata. They loved flying kites. They used to make colorful kites. The boy was always busy. ಈ ಹುಡುಗ ಹೇಗಿದ್ದ? ತುಂಬ ಬ್ಯುಸಿಯಾಗಿದ್ದ. ಎಲ್ಲ ಸಮಯವನ್ನು ಸದುಪಯೋಗ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದ. ವೆನ್ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ನೋ ವರ್ಕ್ ಹಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ಅ ಲಾಂಗ್ ವಾಕ್. ಫ್ರೀಯಾಗಿದ್ದರೆ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದ? ವಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದ. ವಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಹೋಗಿ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದ? ಪ್ರಕೃತಿಯನ್ನು ಸವಿತಾ ಇದ್ದ. ಹಿ ಲವ್ ಟು ವಾಚ್ ದ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿ ಆಫ್ ನೇಚರ್. ಪ್ರಕೃತಿಯ ಸೌಂದರ್ಯವನ್ನು ಸವಿಯುವುದು ಅವನ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಹವ್ಯಾಸ ಅಂತೆ. ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಕ್ಯೂರಿಯಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಅರೌಂಡ್ ಹಿಮ್. ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಮಚ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್. ಹಿ ವಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ನೋ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್. ದ ಬಾಯ್ ವೇಟೆಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಈವ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಡೇ. ಈ ಹುಡುಗ ಸಂಜೆಯ ಸಮಯಕ್ಕೆ ಕಾಯ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಂತೆ. ಯಾಕೆ? ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ಅವರ ತಂದೆಯವರಿಂದ ಕಥೆ ಕೇಳುವ ಸಮಯ. ರಾಮಾಯಣ, ಮಹಾಭಾರತ ಹಾಗೂ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಕಥೆಗಳನ್ನು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರಂತೆ. ದ ಬಾಯ್ ವೇಟೆಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಈವ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಡೇ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಟು ಲಿಸನ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟೋರೀಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಫಾದರ್. ಮೆನಿ ವಿಲೇಜ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಟು ಕಮ್ ಟು ಹಿಸ್ ಫಾದರ್ ಟು ಲಿಸನ್ ಟು ದ ಸ್ಟೋರೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ರಾಮಾಯಣ, ದ ಮಹಾಭಾರತ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ ಸ್ಟೋರೀಸ್. ದ ಫಾದರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಯೂಸ್ ಟು ಪ್ಲೇ ಆನ್ ದ ವೀನಾ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಯಲಿನ್. ದ ಬಾಯ್ ಎಂಜಾಯ್ಡ್ ದ ಸ್ವೀಟ್ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಕ್. ದ ಬಾಯ್ ಎಂಜಾಯ್ಡ್ ದ ಸ್ವೀಟ್ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಕ್. ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಹಾಬಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಾಯ್ ಈಸ್ ಲಿಸ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಕ್. ದ ಬಾಯ್ ವಾಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಟೆಲಿಜೆಂಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡಿಸಿಪ್ಲಿನ್ಡ್. ಶಿಸ್ತುಬದ್ಧವಾಗಿದ್ದಂತೆ. ಆಲ್ ದ ಟೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಲವ್ಡ್ ಹಿಮ್. ಎಲ್ಲ ಗುರುಗಳಿಗೆ ಇವನಂದರೆ ಇಷ್ಟ ಇತ್ತಂತೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅಡ್ವೈಸ್ಡ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಟು ರೀಡ್ ಗುಡ್ ಬುಕ್ಸ್. ದ ಬಾಯ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ರೀಡ್ ಬುಕ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನೇಚರ್. His interest in science grew day by day. Physics became his favorite subject. Physics, Bhautashastra, became his favorite subject. These good hobbies helped him to work hard, to find new things. ಈ ಹವ್ಯಾಸಗಳು ಆತನಿಗೆ ಕಷ್ಟಪಟ್ಟು ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಲು ಹಾಗೂ ಹೊಸತು ಹೊಸತನ್ನು ಹುಡುಕಲು ಸಹಾಯ ಮಾಡಿತು. ವಿತ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಹಾರ್ಡ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಹಿ ಬಿಕೇಮ್ ಅ ಫೇಮಸ್ ಸೈಂಟಿಸ್ಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಗಾಟ್ ದ ನೊಬೆಲ್ ಪ್ರೈಸ್ ಇನ್ 1930. ಡೂ ಯು ನೋ ಹೂ ದಿಸ್ ಬಾಯ್ ವಾಸ್? ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಸರ್ ಸಿ ವಿ ರಾಮನ್. ಹಿ ಇನ್ವೆಂಟೆಡ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಥಿಯರಿ ಆನ್ ಲೈಟ್, ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲರ್ಲಿ ನೋನ್ ಆಸ್ Raman effect. So children, we should have good hobbies. So this boy was having the hobbies like swimming, making friends, flying kites, going for a walk, watching beauty of nature, listening to the stories, listening to music, and reading good books. Let us look at the new words. Hobby, an activity which someone does for pleasure. Curious, interested to know about something. Scientist, one who studies science. Invent, create something new. Students, you can see 4 pictures given here, and you can see some of the words given along with the pictures. So we have to frame sentences now using those words. The first one, push chair. So let us frame a sentence using these 2 words. A boy is pushing a chair. Second one, mix coffee. Mother is mixing coffee. Third one, dry plate. She is wiping the plate to dry it. Sweep floor. A girl is sweeping the floor. Then next one, antonyms. Antonyms are pairs of words which have opposite meanings. Viruddha padagalu. Antonyms. Fill in the blanks in the balloons with their opposites. One has been done for you. Good, bad, smart, dull, friend, enemy, love, hate, long, short, new, old, hard, soft, sweet, bitter. Children, you have to learn these opposites thoroughly. Next one. Identify the underlined words in the following sentences as action words or naming words. One has been done for you. I parked my car near the gate. Here the word park is action word. Action word is also called as verb. There is a park near my house. Here the word park is naming word. Naming word is also called as nouns. I am going to buy a book. Here, book is naming word. Teacher told us to book a ticket for the train journey. Here, the word book is action word. I comb my hair daily. Comb. Comb here is the action word. My sister carries a comb in her bag. Here the word comb is naming word, which is also called as noun. Now the fourth one. Geeta got two gold rings on her birthday. Rings. Rings is, children, can you guess? Yes, it's naming word, noun. Our school attender rings the bell. Now here rings is action word. My dad bought me a new dress. Here dress is noun, naming word. I dress myself carefully before I go out. Here dress is action word. Verb. Children, learn these nouns and verbs thoroughly. Let us look at the grammar, the sentence. Children, here you can see a picture and a sentence given below the picture. Agra, my brother elder, lives in. Children, now you have to tell me, these groups of words do not make any sense. Here you can see one more picture and a sentence given below the picture. Superstar Rajnikanth is a Tamil. These groups of words do not make any sense, children. Flowers do not the pluck. Even these groups of words do not make any sense. A group of words arranged in a particular order which makes a complete sense is called sentence. So these are not sentences. These are not called as sentence. My elder brother lives in Agra. Is Rajnikanth a Tamil superstar? Do not pluck the flowers. Children, these are called as sentences. A group of words arranged in a particular order which makes a complete sense is called sentence. Children, please do remember, begin every sentence with a capital letter. End every sentence with a full stop, a question mark or a sign of exclamation as required. Children, let us learn kinds of sentences. The sentences are of four kinds: statement, interrogative, imperative, and exclamatory. Statements. The Ganga is a holy river. The sun rises in the east. Indian cricketers play the game very well. Children, here these sentences say or state something. These are statements. Then second one, interrogative. Are you a doctor? Will they go to America? Why are you laughing? These sentences ask something. These are questions. So these are called as interrogative sentences. Next one. Imperative. Let us look at the examples for imperative sentences. Do not play on the road. Always speak the truth. Please keep quiet. These sentences are orders, commands, and requests. These are imperative sentences. Then the last one, exclamatory. Exclamatory sentences. May you live long, my child. Alas, Shatakshi is dead. Hello, who is speaking? These sentences express the sudden feelings. These are exclamations. Children, learn these kinds of sentences thoroughly. Statements, interrogative, imperative, exclamatory. Stating something, asking something, orders, and expressing the sudden feelings. Let us look at the homework. Practice different kinds of sentences and write 5 examples for each kind of sentence. You have to write 5 examples for statements. Then you have to write 5 examples for interrogative sentences. Then again you have to write 5 examples for imperative sentences. Then you have to write 5 examples for exclamatory sentences. Children, learn this unit thoroughly. Learn this grammar thoroughly. Thank you.